now we're ready to put the brown coat, or the second coat, on the top of the curb here. Remember, we already put the scratch coat here, and we're going to put the second coat, which is going to be the final coat, on here, on the top of the curb. And I want to show you what I did here. Before I'm going to put the second coat, I actually put three wood to support this piece of wood, which is a 6-inch piece of wood. This wood is flat. There is another wood here, which is also flat, supported with another three wood that attach these two wood to the curb from each side. Remember, we already float these two sides of the curb, and now we're actually going to put the top side of the curb. So this is vital for the successful of this project, and I want to show you why. So these two pieces of wood, flat wood, that's a 6-inch and that is a 3-inch, okay? They are attached by three wood here strongly, and let me show you what's happening here, because if I'm going to put here this level, you will see, very close, I'm going to get closer, that there is a slope of 1/8 here. The way I create the 1/8 slope, you can see here, there is a 1/8 ruler that gives an elevation of 1/8 above this level. And I want to show you what other things I have to do to make it perfect. So remember, this is a flat wood, this is a flat wood. Both of them are attached strongly to the each side of the curb, and between this area to this area, there is an elevation of 1/8 above this area. That to give it a slope. If water coming here, they're going to drop down, they're going to slip toward the shower bath here. So if I would come close to it, you can see first what I did here. So you can see first, it's level, okay, horizontally, and now you can see here is the roller that is sitting above, and that's giving a 1/8 elevation above this wood. Now I put the level on the other side of the curb. Just want to show you how level it is. You can see what's going on. Okay, the other thing I want to show you is, if I'm going to see here, you can see there is here another piece of stick. And that's here, this is the ruler that gives you an elevation. But I had to put this one to correct it, to level horizontally this piece of wood. Okay, now we are going to go on the other side. Let's go to the other side. Now we are on the other side, and you can see here also I put a couple of sticks here. You can see these sticks. This is actually this kind of a stick from Lowe's. Okay, and it costs like, it doesn't cost any money, but it's 1/8 of an inch, each one of them. So you can see what I have to do in order to correct it and to elevate this 3-inch piece of wood to make it ready for the second coat that I'm going to put here in order to float this curve. The other thing I want to show you is this level now, because I showed it before, but now I just want to show it from close to see what's happening here. You see here, I have to elevate it in order to have to get horizontal. You can see what I'm doing here. I'm actually giving up. So we have a 1/8 of a slope here. It's going to be perfect. If I take it here, we will have the same situation. As you can see. So what I'm saying is, all over, wherever I'm going to put it, we're going to have a slope. No matter what, where I'm going to put it here, on the curb, on the top of the curb, we're going to have a slope toward the shower bath. And why I attach this one, these two board here, because I don't need to have any space here. You can see there is hardly any space that actually a mortar will go down between. I don't want the mortar to stick between here, so I want it to be perfect. So that's why I did it like that. And now I can continue just prepare the mortar. And remember, we're going to use the 3701 fortified mortar. Let me show you, from a company called Laticrete. Okay, in order to create this mortar and to float the top of the curve. So before I'm going to float it, I just want to show you something here. If you're getting close to it, you can see that this wood is actually elevated 1/8 of an inch above the first coat, above this top level here. And if you go for the harder side, okay, let's go from the harder side, and I'm going to show you from the harder side. Here, you can see that this is actually is 1/4 of an inch actually above the curb top. To summarize what we did until now, we actually already float the two sides of the curve, and now we're going to actually float the top side of the curve. In order to do it, we actually attach two pieces of wood. One of them is 6-inch wood from here to here, and one of them is 3-inch wood. Both wood are horizontal. This piece of wood, which is the exterior wood, it's elevated 1/8 of an inch above this piece of wood in order to create the slope toward the shower pan. Okay, in order to do it, we're going to use the 3701 fortified mortar in order to float this top. It's going to call the plumb coat, and it's going to be the final coat. I'm using these two tools, these two trowel, to float this the top of the curve. And the first thing I need to do is just need to put it in the water, just wet it a little bit, both of them, and with a sponge remove the excess water from both before you actually put the mortar and floating the top curve. So here is the mortar that I actually mix, the 3701, and let me show you, it's a plastic consistency. And look at that, that's the way it should do. When you actually just stick to it. That's okay, it's very good. And now I'm going to apply it to the curb. So what I'm doing, I'm actually starting from this corner, and I will go from this corner to the left, the other corner, to the right corner here. Okay, I'm putting the material in mortar. And you can see it's a plastic consistency, so it's very easy to press it to the scratch. This is the scratch here, that's the first coat, the scratch coat. Now let's call the brown coat. Okay, it's very similar to stucco, but the material I'm using here is by far better. The mortar I'm using is by far better than stucco, and you can see I'm actually pushing it in. So I'm putting more material that I really need, but don't worry, I'm going to press it and push it. Taking the excess with here. By the way, you have time to do it. It takes it doesn't dry immediately, so you have a lot of time to really play with it. So Now I'm taking this trowel, the big one, and I'm actually pressing and smoothing the mortar. I put it back up and right. You see what I'm doing here? And if I need more material, I'm going to put more material. So here I'm putting more material here because I really need more. So I completed here in this area, and now I'm going to move to this area, that left area, and you need to mix it quite a bit. So you have to force the material, the mortar, inside to the scratch, otherwise it won't be good. You really have to have a good contact with the scratch. So you can see I put a little bit more material that we need, but then I'm going to take all the excess of material back to the bucket here as needed, and I'm going to smooth it using the green foam float. This is a very important tool to actually achieve an extremely nice result. So what I'm doing now, I'm really actually pressing the mortar to the scratch, to the first coat. I really actually apply power here with this mortar, just to make sure that there's a good contact between the mortar and the first coat, the scratch. Also, you need a little bit to wash it every time just to make it slippery. Remove the excess of water from it and just continue. Yeah, removing the excess of the material. See, I'm removing the excess of material while I'm actually packing it. And I'm actually using pressure, really quite a lot of pressure, just to pack it, force it to the scratch. Basically, it's almost finished. I'm going to use the big trowel here to continue smooth it until it will be properly smooth. You see the movement I'm using it? I'm actually moving it back and forward. It's almost done. So the last step is just to take use this trowel. Here I'm just slowly smooth it. Remember just to wet it with water and then remove all the excess water, just make it smooth. Let everything going to be smoothly. You know what I can do now? I can actually take this level and just check to see if the level is perfect. Everything working extremely nice. So it's done, actually it's self-leveling, but I'm going to use now the green foam just to smooth it a little bit, and the work will be done here. So this is the green foam float, and what I did now, I actually wet it and I just remove all the water. But here, it just actually wet, but all the water that was here was removed. I just flip it out, and now I'm going to use this foam just to make it more smooth. You see what I can do, what I'm doing here. I'm actually removing all the excess material. And you can see what's happening here. You just take all the excess material and smooth it. And when it's going to be dry, you won't believe how nice it looks. You also fill up all the small holes in the corners. You fill it up with a mortar. You're going to have a very nice and smooth curve here. Okay, that's the amount of excess, mortar excess that we remove now. And I'm going to really just wash it now and use it again. So I'm back with the new, between the foam after I clean it. So I need to really remove all the water, all the excess water from it. And I'm again doing the same thing. I'm just smoothing it. And what it does, it actually removes excess material from the curve, the top curve. Especially here on the wood. You can see how much excess is left. And I flip it and take now the newest one, and I'm actually going to do it with this. So we're done. So really this green foam is really magic. It does extremely nice job. You don't need to be an expert here. It will do it for you. So this is the last time I really floated with this green float. And you see I'm actually circular, and it's circle movement here. And you can see a little bit of the material actually removed, but the circuit is beautiful. It really smoothed nicely. So that's it, it's done. That's the amount of material we removed, and that's it. So we're going to leave the curb here for 24 hours to let the mortar dry, and then we see the result. But before we going, I want to show you from close distance the result of smoothing the curb, the top of the curb with a green foam float. Let me show you. So if you're going to look at it from close proximity, so you can see how nice the green foam work on this second coat of mortar. And in order to achieve this kind of result, you really need to use this 3701, the fortified mortar that contain polymer. And it's exactly designed especially for putting a porcelain tile on it. So also the strength of this 3701 fortified mortar is 4000 PSI, which is almost 10 times stronger than tinset, normal tinset, even a modified tinset. So let's leave it for 24 hours and we'll come back and see what's happened. Okay, we're back here after 24 hours, and if you look very carefully, you can see how nice it looks. What we need to do now, we need to remove these two wood that support the mortar here, and we see what is the result. It's difficult to remove them, but I will remove them.
Okay, so you're the one.
So you can see how nice it looks. So if you notice here, the color of it is a little bit more grayish. Darker than the color of you. That's because this is already more than a week here, and this is only 24 hours. This color will become grayish in maybe another 24 hours or so. And remember, the PSI of this mortar is 4000. So in 1 or 2 days, it's going to be so strong, it's going to be very, very difficult to remove this floating, unless you're using a grinder or something like that. But it's a very, very stable and very, very solid mortar. So what I'm doing now, actually taking this piece of tile, just a sharp, and just to remove imperfection here. There's not really a little bit of imperfection, so I will take you closer to see how it looks like, and you will see. So let's get close to it and see what's happening here. As you can see what it looks like, and you can see the connection of the layer 2, which is the brown coat, how you see it on the curved top. Okay, there are small imperfections here, but that's when it's a kind of a minor stuff. And what I want to show you here, I really want to use this level here. Okay, I put it here, and I want to show you how horizontal these curves. So if you look here, you can see how nicely horizontal this curve looks like now. This is another look from the inside the shower from the pen, from the shower pen. So I want to show how it looks like. As you can see, that is the final result. But the most important here is that we have the slope. Remember, we actually designed it to have a slope of 1/8 of an inch per
6 inch.
See, let's put it here and let's see if we have a slope. As you can see, if you look very carefully here, I need to actually elevate the level with my hand here, as you can see, just to have it level. If I will leave it like this, as you can see, we have a slope all over the area. If you look here also, so we actually did very well here, and the only thing that left here now is to tile the curb. So this is the way the curb looked like after 3 days. So if you can close, you can see how nice it is. And from the other side, that's from the inside the shower. So you'll put a level and you can see how level it is. Now I put small level, and I want to show you what is going on. If you look here, you can see so there is a slope. You can see the slope here. If I actually take this level and pull it up, this is the slope. I just want to show you a prototype I built before I float the curb in the shower, what we saw before. So if you look here, you can see how I built it. Okay, I actually built it from 2 bricks here, 4 inch, and then I simulate exactly what happened in the shower. You can see the PVC and the metal mesh, and also you can see the floating mortar here. Okay, and what I want to show you is how strong this mortar after a week. And let me show you from the other side here. This is the other side. I didn't finish. It's a scratch that you can see. It's a scratch. So that is nothing but a prototype, but I really want to show you how strong it is. So let me show you. So to demonstrate how strong it is, I'm going to use a 2x4 here, and I show you how strong it is. 3701 fortified mortar there from Latitude. Nothing happened. Write on a hardy baker on other stuff and you will see what's happened. That's it. Finish it.